Jeva Maishe Kitaso Hidartha Jani Shudehan Taravartikeshu Gehe Sujayat Majarati Matsu No Priti Yukta Yavadarthas Chaloki Jeva Maishe Kitaso Hidartha Jani Shudehan Taravartikeshu Gehe Sujayat Majarati Matsu No Priti Yukta Yavadarthas Chaloki. Sisilo Bhakti Siddhanto Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told. Sisilo Bhakti Siddhanto Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada told. Somebody is speaking, don't try to disturb me. I like to stay very in an undisturbed way. Don't try to disturb me. I like to lead a very nice, full, peaceful life. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada speaking. Somebody speaking, I like to lead a very peaceful life. So don't disturb me. Srila Saraswati Thakur speaking, it is also one kind of karma. Actually, it is called passive karma. Not active. You cannot see him. You cannot identify. You have no power. You don't know. It is also one kind of karma. Self-satisfaction. He want. This is also prohibited. This is also prohibited, strictly prohibited. If you want to identify yourself as a member of Gauriya Math, then it is totally prohibited. No question of leading peaceful life. Tomar shevai dukho hai yato sehota param sukh. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Tomar shevai dukho hai yato sehota param sukh. Any kind of problem and eventuality I'm going to face, that's all okay. I like it. Because I like to serve you. I like to serve Guru Pad Padma, I like to serve Guru Gauranga. So any kind of problem can come into my life, I can gladly accept. Come. Kunti Devi, you see, Kunti Devi speaking. Ho Prabhu, Ho Krishna. I want to get different kind of problem to come into my life. Why? Nobody want like that. Yes. Because a problem coming, I can always remember you. I have the chance to remember you. Otherwise, O Supreme Lord, if you give me so much affluences and facility, peaceful condition, nobody disturbing me, I'm not going to remember you. So it's very favorable, positive. I like to get problem to come in my life. So those who are going to identify themselves as a member of Gauriya Math, they should not speak this way. Any kind of problem can come, it's very good. Tomar shevai dukho hai yato seyota param sukh. You must read this kirtan daily to grow that kind of mentality, heart. Why I start with this sloka? Why? What's the reason? Today? Actually, yesterday I was bound to complete fourth canto and I step into fifth canto to starting fifth canto. There I already told that yesterday Priyavrata, Uttanprat Priyavrata. You already know about Uttanprat. I discuss something about Uttanprat, the father of Dhruva Maharaj. You can remember. He is the younger brother of Priyavrata. As per Vedic rules, there is no such system that the younger brother can sit in throne as a king, whereas the elder brother already there. But in this case, it is one kind of unusual event. Because Priyavrata from childhood used to go to forest and meditate onto the lotus feet of Krishna. What to do? He is not staying in palace, in kingdom, always going to forest and meditate, doing bhajan nicely. So actually, Manu Maharaj was bound to make the second son, Uttan Patki. After some time, actually, after a long time, there was such a situation that nobody there to get control over this, you know, kingdom. Then Manu Maharaj was very anxious. He was expecting that now at least he can come back and take control over this kingdom. But he was not ready. By that time he was, you know, going to Mandarachalam Parvat in a cave, doing nice bhajan, only concentrating on the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. In the meantime, Naraji Maharaj also helping him very big way. Naraji Maharaj is the Acharya Bhakti Mar. Naraji Maharaj is the Acharya Bhakti Mar. Naraji Maharaj always ready to help you if you like to do bhajan. So now Naraji Maharaj coming and helping Priyavrata. For a long time Naraji Maharaj helping him. But now specially, in a cave in Mandarachalam Parvati, he is doing bhajan. And Naraji Maharaj giving advice nicely. Yesterday also I was discussing about a point that Parikshit Maharaj expressing some doubt. Yesterday I already told this point. Srila Parikshit Maharaj expressing some doubt in front of his Gurudev, Shukadev Goswami. Hey Gurudev, we heard that he is almost a renounce order. He is a full of bhakti, always, you know, thinking about Supreme Lord, Atmaram. He is Atmaram. He is always self-satisfied. Then why he came back to take the responsibility of this kingdom? Also for those who are free from material, also those who are free from this material bondage, those who are, you know, Atmaram, for them usually this material life is not suitable, favorable. Those who are Atmaram, for them usually we find that family life is not favorable for them. They don't like it. But still we find he come back from forest and took responsibility. What's that? How? We want to know all about. The question was that Priyavrato Bhagavato Atmaramaho Katham Mune Grihe Aramato Janmulaho Karma Bandho Parabhavaha Na Nunam Mukta Sangyanam Tadrishinam Dijarsava Griheshu Avini Vishwayam Pungsam Bhavitu Marhati Mahatam Kholu Viprasiruttam Sloka Padayo Chayanibritto Chityanam Na Kutumbe Sprihamati. This kind of, you know, Atmaram, those who are less interested, they never feel any kind of attraction for son, daughters, wife, kingdom, wealth, riches, nothing. No kind of attachment they feel. It's very excellent. The sloka I started with, excellent sloka. The sloka is very nice sloka, I can explain after. Then Sukhdev Goswami giving honor to the question put by his disciple, Parikshit Maharaj. Well, nice. It's a very important question. Sukadeva Goswami speaking now. Bhadam muktam bhagavato uttama slokasya simat charana rabindu makaran charana rabindam makaranda raso avesita chetaso bhagavato paramahansa daito kathaya kinchit antaraya vihitam swam sivatamam padabhimna praina hinmanti bhadam uktam bhagavato uttama slokasya Simat charanarabindam makarandaraso avesita chetaso bhagavato paramahansa daito kathayam kinchit antaraya vihitam swam sivatamam padavimna prayena hinvanti. Gurudev speaking, Sukhdev, you are right. Usually it is, you are right. But actually those who are, you know, Atmaram, sometimes you see, you can find that they are coming back, they are staying in family life, but still it cannot do any harm to them. You know already, many Grihastha devotees of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, most of them Grihastha. Don't think that Grihastha, in Grihastha life, bhakti is not possible. Don't try to think this way. Grihastha life, if favorable life, 100% you can get bhakti. Bhakti Vinod Thakur, leading Grihastha life, Sivas Pandit, or who not, everybody leading, but still they are enjoying big bhakti. So nice. Sivananda Sen, Champaklata, in, you know, Govindradha Govinda Lila, enjoying full ecstatic feeling. Don't think that way, that in family life it is not possible to do bhakti. I can prove, it is more, you know, practical at present, this Kali Yuga. More practical, I can prove. It's more practical to stay in, you know, family life. Shankar Bhagavan also Grihastha. Shankar Bhagavan to see, I have no bhakti, nothing, you see. I can come to the point where you can see Chitta Ketu Raya, you see. Hey, not Chitta Ketu, actually. Chitta Ketu Raya, yes. Actually, you can find that he was even joking with Shankar Bhagavan. He is big devotee. Paramahansa sitting with, you know, wife here, left side, embracing, what's that, in front of public? He is joking, Shankar Bhagavan laughing. Because Shankar Bhagavan always want to prove that I have no devotion. I have no bhakti, I am material. Those who are having bhakti, they want to prove that I have no bhakti. Those who are not having bhakti, they like to prove I have bhakti. This is a fallacy. Because bhakti means property. Bhakti means property. If you have big amount of property, you are not going to expose in front of government. He can take tax from you. You are not going to prove in front of society that I have so many. Because somebody can come and snatch from you, cut you. This way actually, those who are having property, they always try to keep it secretly, not to expose that I have property. So bhakti is the topmost property, actual property actually. Now you see, Sukadeva Goswami giving argument, right you are, your conception is very good, your argument. But sometimes you see, those who are actually satisfied, saturation, they are meeting saturation, they are feeling saturated, a heart, with the lotus feet of Supreme Lord, when they are feeling. In that case, when their mind and body and sense, everything, full of bhakti. I mean one kind of intoxication. They cannot feel anything other than Krishna. In that case, aveshita means one kind of induction. Faraday's law, you know, in current, physics, you know, Faraday's law, you know, no, nothing. Physics, physical chemistry, actually physics. One kind of induction. Induction in avesh. So they are feeling those paramahamsa dvaita kathayam actually. So in that case, sometime it is not, you know, you can see that they are staying in family life, but still it is not problem for them. No, it was sure. Now question is that why Priyavrata, the great devotee, why he want to go to forest? Why? Because he wanted to avoid material, you know, material life. That's why he wanted to go back to forest and what to do. But one day, actually, Manuji Maharaj was feeling tension. How to do, what to do? He wanted to bring his elder son Priyavrata back. Because situation now is very bad. Situation now very bad. He wanted to come bring him back, you see. In that case, you see, he was appealing to Brahma. Oh, Brahma, Pita, what to do? He is not at all ready to come back. Then one day, you see, when Naraji Maharaj giving nice instruction to Priyavrata in Mandarachal Parvat, very nicely, in front of Priyavrata, at the same time we find, you know, actually Manuji Maharaj reaching there. Manuji Maharaj wanted to bring him back, to request him. In the meantime, miracle, you see, happened. They discovered that Brahma from Sattvaloka descending with one is riding on Hansa. Hansa is a swan and coming down. This is Brahma coming down. When Brahma coming down, they are surprised to see how Brahma coming already.
Atoho Bhagavan Adi Devo Itasya Guno Visargasya Paribrihananu Anudhyana Vyavosita Sakalo Jagad Abhiprayo Atmo Joni Rakhilo Nigama Nijaganu Paribhyasthitah Sabhavanad Avatataraha.
7. Atoho Bhagavan Adi Devo Itasya Guno Visargasya Paribrihananu dhyana babausito sakala jagadabhiprayu atmo yoni rakhila nigamo nijo gana parivishthitaha sa bhavanad avatataraha. I mean, full troops, Brahma with some rishis and everything there, Brahma coming down. And everybody worshipping. Because while Brahma coming down from coming descending, then that time you see, all in different loka. Because Brahma coming from Satya loka, so Bhur Bhuva Swa Maho Yanu Tapo Satya, Bhur Bhuva Swar Maho Yanu Tapo Satya. So when descending, then Tapaloko, Maharloko, Janaloko, already they are worshipping. When Brahma passing through Janaloko, Tapaloko, everybody was saying, oh, this way worshipping. So this way actually, Brahma now coming. It is written, Sa tatra tatra gagano talo udu pati ribu
Vimana Balibhir Anu Patham Mamaru Padi Bidoi Ravipujamanaha Pati Pati Sa Baruthasa Siddho Gandharbos Sadho Charano Muniganai Rupo Giyamano Gandhar Gandhar Gandhamadano Dranin Abhasayan Nipo. It is not Mandrachal Prabhupada, I forget. It is Gandhamadan Prabhupada. I forget, excuse me. I am concentrating about Tattva. So why sometimes? It's Gandhamadan Prabhupada. Not actually, excuse me. So now, actually, everywhere, Siddha, Gandharva, Charan, they are worshipping Prabhu. Because in this Brahmanda, he is Adidev. Brahma is Adidev, even before Sankar. Because Chatushan also come. Chatushan, Brahma, actually Sankar is the younger brother of Chatushan. Chatushan, actually Sankar Bhagavan is the younger brother of Chatushan. Maybe Chatushan looks like 4 hours, 5 years boy, small. No clothes, nothing, naked, bacha, very small. You can kiss, very small. But actually, they are actually very old. Nobody understands. This way, actually, now actually when Brahma coming there, descend, everybody stand up. Naraji Maharaj, Manu Maharaj, Priyavrata, prostrated on Prabhu, you are coming. Now after that, Bhagavan Brahma speaking in front of Priyavrata, Priyavrata. Don't think it otherwise. Don't misunderstand me. I'm coming in front of you with a special purpose. I have no self-interest, be careful. I am always engaged in the service of Supreme Lord, the service given by Supreme Lord. So don't misunderstand me. I have no personal interest. So Brahma now speaking in front of Priyavrata. Nibodo tatidam, nibodo tatidam amritam brabrimi. Ma suitam devam arhasya prameyam bayam bhavaste tato esha maharsir baham sarve vivasaya sadishtam 11. Nibodh tato, listen to me, my grandson. Actually, don't try to take it in a, you know, in a bad way, negative way. You should not express jealousy that reach you to me. Nivedo tato, I am going to give some speech, nectarian speech in front of you. It's not false. Nibodho tati idam amritam babrimi. I am going to speak the nectar. Be careful, me, Sankar, Indra, Varun, all, you know, Lokpal, bayam bhavaste tato esho maharsi bahamu sarvi vivasa yasva dishtam. Dishtam means order. Me, Sankar, all Rishimanis, all, you know, Lokpal, they are bound to obey that Supreme Lord. Be careful first. I am not expressing my fanciful attitude. I am not running my life in a very whimsical way. Not like mad. Not that. Don't misunderstand me. Actually, point is that nobody can break his rules and regulation. Yad bachi tantram sakar gunakaram adam abhi 14. Yad bachi tantram gunakaram adam abhi sudustaro irabatso vayam sujojitaha sarve vaham balimiswarayo. We have two legs. We think we are human beings.
Brahma saying, you see, those beasts, they have four legs. You know, buffalo, and they have bull. Sometimes they are engaged in service by human being. They make hole here, the bull, and tie with rope, you see. When it is, you know, ready, then they are engaging to grind mustard. Previously, now we have messing, you can play switch. And, but previously, it was a system that the bull can rotate round, and one system is there, you can pull mustard, and it become oil and calm down. It's very nice system. So Brahma speaking, actually, we are bound to obey because we have some chain. Maybe sometime, like, you know, beast. Yad bachi tantram gunakarma damabhi sudustarair vatsa vayam sujojitaha. We are engaged. You are bound to get your result of your previous activities. Be careful, remember. Each and everybody, all creature, who not? Everybody bound to get result according to their previous activities. Karma fal. Nobody can avoid it, it's a must. It's a must, nobody can avoid. Everybody going to get the result of his previous activities. Nobody can avoid. So in Shastra it is written nicely, nobody can avoid. Nobody can avoid it. Avasyameva bhaktyabhyam kita karmam subhasubham. Avasyameva bhaktyabhyam. Avasya, it's a must. Everybody can get result according to their previous activities. You need not play your head. So Brahma speaking, we all, you see, all Jivatma here. What about Jivatma? We actually, I am Brahma, Shankar, Varun, Indra. Everybody, they are bound to follow. Even Rishi Manis. Yadvacha tantram guna karma dam abhi sudustarair vatsa vayam yoyitaha. Oh, my son. Hey, grandson, beloved, we are actually engaged. Sarve Bahama Balimishwarayo Prota Nasiva Dipade Chatuspat. Sarve Bahamo Balimishwarayo. We are all approaching the Supreme Lord with some gift. Bali, you know, tax, you know? You cannot remember. To king, you need to pay tax. Like Nanda Maharaj giving to Mathura to pay tax to Kamsa. Here also you see, Sarve Vahama Balimishwarayo, Balimin, gift, and tax. Ishwarayo, the Supreme Lord, we are bound as if a beast, you know, tied with a nose. And when anybody pulling, come, is in a bonded here, so is bound to move. Brahma speaking this way. So now actually, I like to give a nice argument in front of you, my grandson. Try to think this point over and again. Very nice argument. You cannot cut it. Brahma forehead, so much intelligence here. Speaking in front, you have one head, very small brain. Brahma speaking, oh my grandson, bhayam pramattasya banesho pishat jataha so aste sahasat patnya. Bhayam pramattasya banesho pi swat yataha so aste sahasat patnya. Jitendraya Swatma Ratir Buddhasya Grihasramaha King Nukarati Avadhyam. 17. My boy, try to understand this point. Suppose you are going to forest to get free from any kind of problem, it's okay. But while you are going to forest, you are going to forest with all your sense organs and your material mind. Your material mind following you. Your mind is material mind. I already discussed this point in Gita. Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking to Arjun. Bhumi rapo analo. Vayu khang mana buddhi revacha. Ahankar ithyam me prakriti rastada. My prakriti nature in 8 divided form acting on you. Your mind is not your mind. It is coming from this nature. Your mind is material mind. When you become great devotee, then your mind is then not material mind anymore. But until and unless you develop 100% submission and niskinchana bhakti, till then you will have to carry your mind. You have to carry anywhere you go. Maybe in America, Russia, France, Italy, wherever you like to go. Or maybe in Himalaya you can go. Eh? But what it concerns to us? But anyway, you are going to carry your mind, material mind with you. And that material mind going to put you in disturbance. Because mind is material. You are flying in forest. You are going to forest with your material mind. That material mind going to put you in trouble because mind is material, is still one. You are not in a position to get control over your mind and sensor. Do you? If you can get control over your sense organ and mind, because mind is the 11th, number 11th, a topmost leader of all sense organs. Mind is the leader of all. Though you cannot see mind, it is named as number 11th. Number 11th, the strongest of all sense organs. Pancha Karmandriya, 5 Karmandriya and 5 Ganandriya. And mind is acting as a leader and topmost of all.
Bhayam pramatasya banishu api shat yataho saaste shahasa tupatnya 17. Yitendriya swatmaratirvadasyo grihasramah kingnu karuti avadyam.
When you are running to forest, you are going to take all your material sense organ and mind with you there. You are trying to do bhajan. Still you can feel problem. You are going to forest. No problem there. But when you close your mind, you can find Italy is there, Bombay is there, Calcutta is there, everything. Because this like dust particle in air. Try to follow my point. Like dust particle in air, if a beam of light coming inside your room, you can watch that in sunlight, billions of, dust particle, This infinity universe is like that dust particle, Anantadev. Anantadev is there, and like dust particle all flying. Hold up by the desire of Anantadev. Ananta, Hari Ananta, Hari Rupa Ananta. Now point is that, like dust particle you can find, in suspensions and suspension in air, also in water, if you take some water sample, if you see those biological scientists, they can speak, in suspension you can find so many germs and bacteria you can find in water. so many in suspension. Is, you know, like that, your mind, you think your mind is pure. But if you think over and again, go to a solitary phase, you avoid a satsanga, you can find that you, though you are staying very lonely, but still you are not lonely. You are lonely? Not. Gaurkisarova was lonely? Actually, Gaurkisarova was lonely. Because he is going to get the association of pure Vaishnavas. Those who are pure Vaishnavas, believe me, I am sitting in Vyasasana. Believe me, 100%. What I feel that I am speaking. I am not joking, I am not speaking any philosophy, false philosophy, nothing. What I realize, out of the kippa of my Guru Maharaj, I am speaking. Those who are pure Vaishnava, those you can find there in lonely place, Maharaj. He is also there in lonely place. But actually believe, they are not in lonely place. All the time they are thinking about that Guru Varga, Supreme Lord, Vamshidas Babaji Maharaj, Gaurkisar Babaji Maharaj, Bhagavandas Babaji Maharaj, Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj. They are not actually, all the time they are doing satsanga. Apparently it seems they are staying, leading their lonely life. Not that. Not that. So when you go to a solitary place and sit very peacefully, but still you cannot get peace because your mind is restless. If you look into your mind, you can find thousands of things there in suspension in your mind. Like ether, you see, like space. Those who are philosopher, topmost philosopher, they compare this mind with this space. In space you can find all, you know, dust particle, everything, after all, in galaxy way, all stars and planets, they hold. Similarly, if you can look into your mind, you can find Bombay is there, Italy is there, Rome is there, everything there. All your children, all your husband, all your wife, all liquid money, everything there, fulfilled. But in fine form. Follow. Matter is not in coarse form, but is in fine form there. Woman is there, not there inside your mind, but woman is there inside your Jashit is there inside your mind. Very fine form. Follow. Very fine form is already there. You cannot avoid. So it is the prescription given by all, you know, unique prescription by all Guru Varga. Not to go to a very lonely place. It was a system at the time of Gauriya Math when came here first, Chaitanya Math, and now Gauriya Math. It was a system. Prabhupada said the system. No brahmachari, no sannyasi can stay alone. One, you know, big room. All brahmachari can stay. Nobody can stay alone. At present, we are going to allow separate room for one sannyasi, one brahmachari. Oh, he is very powerful. He is powerful? Really? No. He is very weak. Weak means who is weak? Who is weak? Who has no control over his mind and sense organ. He is weak. Maybe externally you have big appliances and big power. But you are actually weak. Ravan can prove that I am, you know, a mighty man. But we can prove Ravan is, you know, the lowest, you know, creature in this Brahmanda. Hiranyakasipu can try to prove. Ravan is more and more weak than you. Because every fraction of second he is thinking about Kamini Kanchan. To get control over this universe. I'm king. This kind of mentality is totally prohibited. Prabhupada speaking, those who like to get name and fame and position, they are much more weak than you. Follow. If you like to get control, if you like to take control over this society, then you are going to meet with big problem. It's a kind of big bondage for you. I can discuss this point tomorrow. So, my boy, you try to think over and again. Bhayam pramattasya vanesho pishad jataha swaste sahasata patnya. One man, he is living with six wives. Brahma giving this argument. One man staying with six wives at a time. Brahma giving this argument in front of, you know, this Priyavrata, try to consider, try to, you know, understand this point. If a man having six wives, then where to go? Every wife can, you can stay with me. Every wife, this way, fighting, infighting. Yataha swaste sahasata patnya. Sahasata patnya means satin, step. You know, step wife. They six wives. In that case, big problem. That man can meet with big problem. Same thing happened. Those who are jitendriya, those who are having control over their sense organ, even they are staying with this material life, still no problem can touch them. If they have control over their sense organ, jitendriya, if they are going to stay in America, France, Italy, Russia, Swami Maharaj sitting in America, with all hippie around him, yes, but no problem with Swami Maharaj. But is the same thing with you? Gosai Maharaj going, Bhano Maharaj going. Last Srila I heard, Srila Bhakti Vallabh Tirtha Gosai Maharaj going to some place. Some place. Where actually is big problem, but no problem for Bhakti Vallabh Tirtha Gosai Maharaj. So, you see, Yitendriya Swatma Ratir Budhasya Grihasramaha Kingnu Karoti Avadhyam. What problem you can feel in Grihastha life, whereas if you have a total control over your sense organ? Try to consider this point, my boy. At the same time, you can get extra facility in this family life. This in this family life, it is, you know, Brahma speaking, it is like, you know, ford, you know, those big king, they are making ford. So inside ford, some battalion there, they are fighting with enemies. After that, after fighting for 8 hours, then another batch coming, now this batch going to take rest and take bath, prasadam, taking rest. In the meantime, they are fighting. And Durga mean fort. Nobody can watch you from where you are fighting. You have seen fort? Holes, different kind of holes. From there you can fire. Nicely. Now Brahma speaking this argument, giving this argument, is like fort. The Grihastha man, Grihastha devotees, they can worship Supreme Lord. They can engage their daughter and, you know, children, I mean, boys in seva. Wife is a maidservant of Supreme Lord. This way they can engage all their resources, I mean, money, everything what they have. Everything for the service of Krishna. Brahma giving this same argument, 18th sloka. Ya satapatnyano bijigisho mano griheshu nirvishyo jateta purvam atteto durgastrito urjita rino khinesu kamam visharet vipaschit. Try to consider this point, my boy. Suppose you are put it into a durga fort, then you have extra facility to fight with enemy. You are going to get food and water, everything, medicine, all there in durga, so no disturbance. After that, Brahma giving this argument, now suppose you are put into family life. I know you have realization. I'm not speaking that you have no realization. Still more, if you like to increase your realization, if you like to get more and more power, gather more and more power, better you go to family life and try to protect yourself, very adjusted by Yukta Vairagya, like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving advice to Raghunath. Sthir hoya ghare jao, naho batul, krame krame pai loke bhavishindu kul. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving to argument, giving instruction to Raghunath. Go to room, go to a home peacefully. Don't try to feel any disturbance. Go. And try to maintain yukta vairagya, balance vairagya. Sthir hoya ghare jao, naho batul. Don't be crazy. Go to room. Go to your home. And gradually, by the mercy of Krishna, you can get green signal. Gradually, by the mercy of Supreme Lord, krame krame pai loke bhavishindu kul. This material ocean, it is impossible for you to cross this material ocean without the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, without the mercy of, you know, Krishna. You cannot cross this material ocean. It is ocean, endless ocean. Who can cross? So Pitamaha Brahma giving argument. My boy, you go back and try to think this way, that you are put it into a, you know, Durga fort. You are enjoying extra facility to maintain your strength, you are going to get more and more energy. You can fight with enemy. What enemy? What kind of enemy? No enemy there? Yes, enemy there. Kama, Krodha, Lobha, Moha, Mascharja. All enemy. Why you are looking out, searching out your enemy outside this world? Prabhupada speaking, enemy is there inside your... Inside you, enemy. No enemy is there. Try to rectify yourself. First advice Prabhupada giving. It is my advice to you all. Try to rectify yourself. Don't try to find fault with others. I can discuss this point tomorrow morning. First, starting. Ya satopatnyano viji gisho. Anna. Ya satopatnyano viji gisho mano. Griheshu nirvisha jati topurvam. Atiti durga srito. Urijitarino khineshu kamam charit vipaschit 18. Ya satapatna kam krodha lobha moha ascharya as a six enemies staying inside your body, man mind. If you can take shelter of a, you know, fort, you can fight with them very vigorously and defeat them. Then no problem, you can travel anywhere. You can go to America, France, Italy, anywhere, no problem. Tvam tvajjanavangri saroja koso durga srito nirjito ho sato sapatna bhunkhe ho bhogano purushati dishtan vimukta sango prakritim bhajasya. Tvam tvajjanavangri saroja koso durga srito nirjito sato sapatna bhunkhe ho Bhogano purushati dishtano vimukt sangha prakritim bhajasya. First I would, you know, advise you that tvam tu, first of all, you take the shelter of Guru Vaishnava and Bhagavan. Here is written Supreme Lord, where I elaborately am speaking. Tvam tu abjo navangri sarojo koso durgasrita. First you try to take shelter of the Supreme Lord, lotus feet. It is like a Durga. Maybe you are put into family life, you think you are in Durga, fold. And you are taking shelter of the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. Oh Prabhu, where is my rank and position? I am always on, I am staying. What is your address? Somebody asking to Popa, What is the address of your Gurudev? To insult Prabhupada. Some Sahaji asking, what is the address of your Gurudev? Where staying? They want to insult him. Because go give no temple, nothing. Saying at the bank of Ganga. Prabhupada speaking, yes. Actually, the address of my Guru Padma, permanent address, is the lotus feet of Srimati Radharani, Radhakund. But at present, he is staying in Kulia. Follow my point. Very smartly, Prabhupada give me answer. The Sahaji has set up. Sahaji cannot speak even a single word in front of a powerful Vaishnava. To tvam tu arjuna bhangri sarojo kosa durgasrito nirjito sato patnyaha sato sapatnyaha. You try to defeat and, you know, drive all the six enemies. Though there is no enemy there with, you know, Priyavrata, but Brahma giving this argument to bring him back, to engage in the service of creation, given that, this service given to Brahma by Supreme Lord. He also like to transfer, delegate this authority. So he is giving, oh my boy, tvam tu bhunkho, tvam tu bhunkheho, bhogano purushati dishtano, vimukta sanga prakatima. You, if you lead your life this way, automatically you are free from material bondage. Still, you try to stay here. I mean, enjoy this material, you know. Enjoyment? Bhunkho, actually, I cannot see this, speak this way. Bhunkho means actually enjoy. But Priyavrata anyway not going to enjoy. So I can get this meaning this way. That you can stay and maintain your life with Jukta Vairagya. This meaning is perfect. But anyway, Brahma, though speaking, bhunkheho, in this material world, you try to enjoy. No, I cannot get this meaning this way. I like to speak this way, Yukta Vairagya. What you need for your body, if you need some water, you can drink. What's for your body, if you need some fruits, you can offer to Krishna and take. It depends how your body can maintain, how you can maintain your body. It's called Yukta Vairagya. There should not be any attraction at all. Bhakti may talk of maintaining family life. But still, all the 24 hours he is doing bhajan. He is acting as district magistrate, sitting in his own helm, in chair, by interval time. Half an hour interval there, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing kirtan. In diary, reading kirtan. Oh my God! Half an hour only, break in between. Bhaktivinoda Thakur sitting in chair, writing kirtan. Tumi to amar, ami to tomar, kikaj aporadhane. Or writing kirtan. So we are getting countless kirtan. Who is going to help you, like Bhaktivinoda Thakur? Try to think over and again. You are really lucky to come here. Be careful. I can solemnly say that you are really lucky, but still you are unlucky because you cannot understand. This way, you see. So, Brahma requesting. Now, Sukhdev Goswami speaking, Priyavrata very attentively hearing this, all these arguments given by grandfather. Now, he is most powerful, so wanted to accept and speaking this way. Iti samovhi hato mahabhagavato. Bhagavato stivuvano gurur onu sasanam atmono alohu taya bono to siro dharu baramiti sabahumanam ubahu. He is topmost authority here in this inward Brahma. So iti samabhito, very carefully is accepting accepting all the advice by Brahma, I am speaking, okay, Bhadam iti, sa bahumanam mubaha. He gives the honor to the advices of his grandfather, and he wanted to come back in this world to take control over this kingdom. This way, Priyavrata, now, you know, very nicely, Priyavrata, you know, ruling the whole world. Priyavrata is so powerful, you cannot understand. Priyavrata is so powerful. Now, actually, Priyavrata married the daughter of Vishwakarma, one demigod there in heaven. He is an engineer of construction. Yes, he is an engineer. And Maidanov is the engineer, those are demons, they are having more extra technology than Maidanov, knowing so much technology. Even more than, you know, Vishwakarma, the, you know, engineer of, you know, heavenly planet. Now what to do? Vishwakarma is his daughter, is Bohismati. So now Priyavrata marry Bohismati and leading family life nicely. What to do? Having giving birth to four, you know, boys and one daughter. Daughter name is Ujjaswati. And 10 sons, their name I can speak. Agnidhra, Idmojivho, Yagyabahu, Mahaviro, Hiranareta, Ghritopristos, Sabano, Medhatiti, Vitihotro, Evam Kobi. These are the four, you know, sons. Then the daughter is Ujjaswati, one daughter actually. Priyavrata also another wife, second wife, because those are king, they are having, it is a rule there, Kshatriya. There, Priyavrata, another wife, he is getting three more sons, Uttam Tamasa Raivato. Very powerful. After that, Priyavrata ruling this whole world. Whole world means seven, you know, Mahadeep. Deep. Seven Asla you can find, whole world. Island you can. Seven. Shat Sapto Dipadhipati. Sapto Dipadhipati. So now Priyavrata took decision. You know, Priyavrata took decision to divide his, you know, whole world into seven, you know, different parts. And you can get Priyavrata, when running his chariot, you know, that time, actually, he makes seven seas. When Priyavrata running horse, then seven seas created. Very powerful. You cannot compare his personality with your personality. Be careful. Then you can express doubt and fall down. Be careful. It's so powerful. Then there's, you know, Priyavrata making seven islands. Jambu, Prakno, Salmali, Kuso, Kroncha, Sako, Puska. Out of that is Jambudip, in which you are at present doing bhajan. Jambudip. Jambu, Prakno, Salmali, Kruso, Kroncho, Saka, Puskar. This. And outside of each island, you can find each, you know, sea, ocean, different kind of. Lavanjal, you can say Lavan ocean, Ikshu. Ikshu means actually the sugar cane, you can get juice. But don't think there is a nice philosophy. You cannot understand, you can misunderstand. So I like to, you know, speak very lightly. So, lavan jal, lavan water, there was salty water, ikshu jal, you know, sura jal, ghrito jal, dodhi jal, dugdo jal, and suddho jal. Jal means water. This way I explain. After that you say, now actually Priyavrata wanted to go to Bhajan again because it Brahma already told you. First you try to live family life and get, rule this whole world. After there's some time coming, you can get the facility to come back again and do Bhajan nicely. So Priyavrata now thinking, my boys, you know, they are all grown up. They are. So Agnidhra, he choose Agnidhra, the first son, to, you know, make him king. He make him king of Jambudip. Jambudip. You know, Agnidhra was engaged in Jambudip. Follow. Agnidhra was engaged in Jambudip. Jambudip was the king of Jambudip. So one day Agnidhra wanted to marry because father wanted to give him away in marriage. He also interested to marry a right personality. So first he took decision to go to Mandarachalapa. This is Mandarachalapa. I forget. Now he is going to Mandarachalam Parva to do bhajan nicely, to get power, enough power, to now to go for family life and both family life and to get control over this universe. Supreme Lord knowing this thing, Supreme Lord knowing everything, he is going to forest to do bhajan, Mandarachalan Parva, to get matching, you know, wife. But, exact. See, after that, Supreme Lord sending Viprochiti, one heavenly lady, Viprochiti, was sent Apsara. Supreme Lord sending this Apsara, Viprochiti, there, so that Agnidhra can marry, love her, and can enter into family life nicely. That's why it is the planning of Supreme Lord. So Supreme Lord actually sending Viprochiti. Somehow Viprochiti coming in this Mandarachalam Parvat and making different kind of, you know, making problem for Agnidhra to break his bhajan. Somehow she was successful and actually this, you know, Agnidhra was totally attracted by that, you know, lady who, Viprochiti, ultimately marry her. This way, after that we find, Agnidhra married that Viprochiti. After that you see, Viprochiti, you know, he give birth to 9 different boys, you see. Agnidhra, Raja Agnidhra, Sei Viprochiti Raja Agnidhra, Nabhi, King Purusho, Harivarsho, Ilabrito, Ramyog, Hiranway, Kuru, Bhadrasro, Ketumal. 9 different sons give birth to. Who all them? I already told. Nabhi, King Purush, Harivarsho, Ilabrito, Ramyog, Hiranway, Kuru, Bhadrasro, Ketumal. Actually, those are the division of this, you know. This land, India, was divided into, Jambudi was divided into 9 different parts. I can speak about it after, but now you try to listen this word only. The Nabhi was very powerful. Nabhi took charge. Nabhi who? First, you know, this Nabhi, first son. After that, Agnidhra wanted to enter into bhajan. So after that, he gave responsibility to Nabhi. Nabhi dham nam actually. Actually, Nabhi, he married Merudevi. Merudevi actually married Merudevi and also doing bhajan, yogya purush aradhana karen, doing worshipping this yogya purush. At the same time, he is leading life with, you know, Merudevi and expecting a nice boy to come in their life was just powerful like Supreme Lord. Nabhi and Merudevi, both husband and wife, this couple started doing jagya bhajan nicely to satisfy the Supreme Lord with a motive to get a nice powerful boy, just like Supreme Lord. Supreme Lord could understand the motive of, you know, Nabhi. So he was bound to appear in front of Nabhi in jagya, very powerful, and blessing him. What do you want? Actually, we want to get a boy like you. But Supreme Lord speaking, who can be compared with me? Nobody is there. I am unparalleled, unbeaten. So I am thinking, I myself can come as boy, because nobody there. You are expecting a child like me. Who is there? Nobody can compare Supreme Lord to anybody. So now Supreme Lord took decision to come himself as a son in the life of that, you know, couple. Now he is coming as, you know, very nice Nabhi. Then is getting Rishabhadev. You get Rishabhadev. Rishabhadev is the incarnation of Supreme Lord. Rishabhadev came, you see, very, very nice. Now Rishabhadev is not ordinary personality. He is the incarnation of that Supreme Lord. When Rishabhadev took birth here, all different kind of auspicious, you know, symptoms took place. Like some demigods throwing, you know, pushpa throwing, and so nice symptom everywhere, you know, small raining, very light raining, so many things. Now when Rishabhadev, you know, growing up, just sufficiently grown up to get control over this, you know, kingdom, then with Merudevi, this Nabhi with Merudev wife, they both going to Badrikasram to do bhajan there nicely, Naranarayan, because in, you know, Naranarayan is there, where is Badrikasram? At the bank of Alakananda, you can find Narayan, you see, in the form of one hill, big hill. We pay this Naro and Narayan, two hills there. Now they are doing bhajan nicely, and they get the keep of Naranarayan, and they are successful. Very nice, actually. After that, the Rishabhadev, Rishabhadev took decision to perform some duties, very nice duty. One vital point is that as per Veda, one vital, very nice point. As per Veda, this Bharat Varsha is the place where you can do karma khetra. Be careful. In the whole world, only India is the place, a field of karma khetra. No other place is karma khetra. Karma khetra mean? What do you mean by karma khetra? Karma khetra mean, if you want to, you know, follow all Vedic rules and regulation, you can apply rightly in India. Karma khetra. Karma khetra mean? instruction given in Ved, different kind of instruction given in Ved, that instruction you can follow rightly in India only. This is actually, it is called Karma Khetra. Or other place there in the whole world, there is not Karma Khetra. Be careful. That's why you see, Karma Khetra actually, Nabhi is so powerful. And after that, you see, Nabhi gone. After that, Rishabhadev, Rishabhadev actually first went to Gurukul. Rishabhadev first gone to Gurukul to give us a lesson that it is a very urgent on your part to go to Gurukul and take lesson there. Through Guru Seva, if you get lesson, it's best perfect lesson you can get. Previously, it was a system. Any boy taking bath, first of all, in childhood, after the grown adolescent, then father and mother sending him to Gurukul, and after that, in that, there they can grow and take lesson, do some seva, Guru Seva, this way they can get maturity to do Hari Bhajan nicely. Also, if they are entering into at all into family life, that also can be done. Both facility there. One can go for family life, another after Gurukul they can start bhajan and enter into renounce order. Both there. So after that, actually, Rishabhadev took decision to marry Jayanti Devi. Jayanti Devi, one nice daughter, Indrudatya, Jayanti Namini Bharjat. Indra actually giving this Jayanti. This Jayanti, as a wife, Rishabhadev accepted, marry actually. After that, you see, Rishabhadev, you see, after that, you said doing bhajan for a long time, and giving birth to 100 boys. They are very most powerful. They are very powerful, actually. The first boy is Bharat Maharaj. First boy is Bharat Maharaj, in whose name this India is given Bharat. This name Bharat came from Bharat Maharaj. So this way, first boy is Bharat Maharaj. After that, first boy Bharat Maharaj, another 9 boys I can name. Kushavarto, Ilavarto, Brahmavarto, Malayo, Ketu, Vhadros, Sheno, Indros, Prik, Vidharbo, and Kikot. 9 boys. Follow, you see. After that, Navayogendra means, Kobir Havir Antariksha Prabuddha Piplayan Avirhatra Dravir Chamasa Karabhajan, this 9. So first who? Bharat Maharaj. After that I speak the name of 9 boys. After that I speak the name of another 9 boys in Navayugendra. So the rest is 8 to 1. We calculate. First 1, after 9, 10, another 9, 19, and the rest 81. These rest 81 boys, they become very powerful Brahmin. Rest 81, they become most powerful Brahmin. Now you can put question in front of me, Maharaj, how is that possible? Whereas Rishabhadev is actually Kshatriya. Though he is actually Supreme Lord, incarnation of Supreme Lord, I know. But Priyavrata Kshatriya. Priyavrata Kshatriya. So naturally he is also Kshatriya. Because by Siddhanta coming, it depends upon their, you know, quality. I can discuss this point very, you know, big way. In 11th canto, I can discuss this point. I can remember, I cannot forget. I can remember this point. Who is Brahman, who is no? In 7th canto also you can find Ajagar Tapasvi. Ajagar Dattatva in the form of Ajagar Tapasvi. Lying down in one place. In front of Ajagar Tapasvi, you know, this is our Prahlad Maharaj putting some question. Also, after that we find Nahus Raja asking question to, you know, Yudhishthira Maharaj. Oh, Yudhishthira, who is Brahman? Who is Brahman? Yudhishthira Maharaj speaking, actually, to be frank, you see, he who is having strong affinity for Supreme Lord, following all rules and regulations, he is actually Brahman. Nishtha in Brahman, Nishtha in Brahmo is called Brahman. Because Yudhishthira Maharaj is giving argument, O Raja Nahus, how I can speak, he is Brahman, he is Brahman. Sometimes we find unusual factors. Anybody can take birth from anywhere. Agastya Muni took birth, Vasishtha from Kumbha. Kumbha means pitcher, kolsi. From kolsi, pitcher, where we can put water. Dronacharya from, you know, the cap in which you put arrow. So, how different way you can take birth? It's not a matter, it depends upon the quality you have. And Scorpio, you see, Kakrabicha. Sometimes we find the father and mother of Scorpio. But sometimes not. From crude rice, Atapchal. If you put crude rice, you know, not boiled rice. If you put for 5 years, 10 years, 2 years, you can buy it, get, you know, from there you can get Kakrabiche. You know, biche, Scorpio. So this way we cannot, there's no exact definition who is Brahman, who is not. I can give total discussion, I can put in front of you. How Gautami Muni, Gautami Rishi in front, speaking in front of Jabal Satyakam. So is Brahman, who is not? It depends upon the quality that you develop. Not that forcefully, my father is Brahman, I am Brahman, not that. Here you find the rest 81 boys of Rishabhadev, they become topmost Brahman in India. They are Santa, Dantya, Upa, you know. Now actually this, you know, Rishabhadev worship him Supreme Lord, 100 Yajna performing. After that, someday Rishabhadev calling all his 100 boys, my boys, you come and take seat here, take seat here. I am going to give you nice advice because I am going to leave. I am going to leave shortly. So before that, I like to give some advice to you all. So be careful. Give attention. Your attention, please. Rishabhadev now giving advice in front of all his 100 boys sitting there in front. And Rishabhadev speaking, very shortly, I am going away from this material world. So I have no time. So you all sit, I am going to speak some special advice to you all. Rishabhadev giving unique advice, if I like to discuss all in details, it will take long and long time. But I can read nicely, you can enjoy hearing also. Because extraordinary power is there in sloka. I can explain in gist. Rishabhadev speaking.
Nayam deho deho bhajam niloke kaschanukam ara hati birabhujam je topo divyam putra kajena satyam suddhed yasmad brahma shakshantu anantam nayam deho deho bhajam niloke kaschan kam a kaman arhate bidabhujam je topo divyam putra kajena satyam suddhed yasmad brahma shakshantu anantam mahasvebam dharmahu vimukte stamodaram yasitam sangi sangyam mahantaste samachitta prasantya vimannavah sruhido sadabhoje jevamaishe kitasauhidartha janeshu dihantarvartikeshu geheshu yayatma yaratimatsu naprid yukta yavadarthascha loke nunam pramato kurute bikarmo jadindriyo pri tayo aprinoti na sadhu manne yatvatmanoyam am asannopi kleshadu asadeho parabhavastabadabudhyato yavanna jigyasito atmatatyam yavat kriyastabadidam manovai karmatmakam jena sorirabandho evam manu karma basam prajukto avidyatmo nyupadhiyamane pitirna javad muivasudeve namochate deho yoge natavad. This way, nice sloka. Oh my boys, oh my son, this human body. Nayam deho deho bhajam niloke kastan kaman kamana rahate birabhujam je. Oh my boys, actually this body is not given to you for enjoyment. Be careful. This body is not given to you for enjoyment. This body is not given to you for enjoyment. Then for what? This kind of enjoyment also you can find in the life of pig and dogs. Swami Maharaj used to say, God and dog and cat society. Swami Maharaj used to say, dog and cat society. Yes, society. Nayam deho deho bhajam niloke kastan kaman ahate birabhujam je. You can find this kind of material enjoyment in the life of those cats and dogs and pigs. What speciality there with this kind of enjoyment? So you'll have to go for tapa. Be careful, my son. Tapa, by tapa you can get power. Tapo divyam putraka yena satyam shuddheda yasmad brahma shakshamanantam. If you can go for astuti and finances, tapasya, then you can purify your heart. What is your tapasya? We go here to do sankirtan. Parambhiyata Sri Krishna sankirtan is all our astuti and finances. We can follow Akadasi, more and more Harikatha. Not that morning time, 3 hours Harikatha. Whole day and night, all is echo going on. Guru Maharaj speaking, Harikatha, Prabhupada speaking. Echo! Yes, transcendental sound. The scientists are speaking, sound you cannot destroy. In Itha, they have some vibration frequency. They like to cast the advice of Krishna in Kurukshetra battlefield. Those scientists, they are trying. But they cannot do it. Krishna is so clever. The voice of Krishna is transcendental. Your experiment is a material, how you can touch. Though scientist speaking, whatever you are speaking in this material world, is not ever destroyed. It is with some frequency dancing.
So you see, Rishabhadev giving advice, and so through astity and finance, we are doing Akadasi, we are following Janmashtami, Radhashtami, and main astity is Sankirtan. But anyway, tapasya, through tapasya you can get power, no doubt. Through tapasya you can get power. So now, Rishabhadev speaking, who wise, if you can undergo different kind of astuary and finances, so gradually you can grow your power inside you and you can purify your heart also through tapasya. Like gold, if you, those goldsmith, you know, they try to burn gold in fire. They like to put, you know, gold in fire. Then gradually they can get more and more. It is 20 carat gold. It is, you know, 16 carat. It means gradual purification. The more you purify, the gold become more and more. You can get in purified form. So if you undergo astuti and finances, naturally you are going to purify. But for us, Gauriya, Sankirtan is best, topmost. Because, you know, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking, Kirtaniyar Parishram Jane Gaur Rai. Mahaprabhu speaking, Jagadananda speaking. Those who are doing Sankirtan, their energy, how much energy they need to do Sankirtan, only Gauranga Mahaprabhu, the Sankirtan Pita Noi. How much energy, how much blood I am putting in front of you are foolish, you cannot know. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Noi. How much blood I am giving for you? So, Sankirtan, for Sankirtan, you have to put all your energy for Sankirtan. Oh, my boys, try to go for Sadhu Sangha. And you will have to serve Mahat Bhakti. Oh, my boys, this body is not for material enjoyment. On the contrary, you will have to do bhajan. Through bhajan, astutian bhajan, you can purify yourself. You have to serve those elevated devotees. You will have to serve those realized souls. You will have to serve those realized souls, you see. That's why advising Mahat Sevam Daro Mahu Vimukte. If you serve one realized soul, you can cut your bondage and find one nice gate to go out of this material bondage. That's why it is written, I speak the sloka, you cannot remember. Mahat sevam dharmahu vimukte stvam dvaram yasitam sangi sangyam mahat sevam dharmahu vimukte mahat sevam dharmahu vimukte ahu mane mahu mane. It is called that Mahatsabha is a gate of liberation. You can get free from material bondage. Mahatsabham, Mahatsabham dar mahu vimukte stamo dvaram yasitam sangi sangyam. If you like to get the association of yashit, then it is, you know, you can go to darkness. Tama, you know? Go gradually. Fall down. Stamo dvaram yasitam sangi sangyam. Yashit and those who, they are getting the association of yashit, both. Very dangerous. So anyway, yashit sangha for you and those who are going for yashit sangha, both those. For you, you have to be very careful. You have to avoid that kind of association because it is in a it's a bondage. Yashitam sangi sangyam. Yashitam sangi sangyam tamodaram. Tamodaram, you know, you can go down and down in ignorance. Then after that, I was speaking this sloka when I started. Jeba mayi she kita sauhidartha
Yaneshu dehantarvartikeshu geheshu jayatma jarati matsu na priti yuktva yavadarthascha loke.
Those who are growing strong affinity, those who are growing strong relationship with me, try to understand. Je ba mui ishe. In Sanskrit, if I split up this way, je ba mui ishe kito sauhidartha. Mui ishe. I am Supreme Lord. Those who are growing strong relationship with me, strong affinity they are feeling, is very good. Jeva mahishe kito sohidartha. Sohidartha means friendship. Yane sudhyan taravartikeshu grihesu yatma jaratimatsu napriti yukta yavadartha saloge.
Then automatically they are losing affinity for material samsara.
Automatically. They are going to lose, Yanesu dehantaravartikeshu. They are going to lose, kind of attraction for this material world. All wife, children, money, liquid money, land and other kind of properties of friends. All losing, less interested. Less interested. So when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving advice to Raghunath, what kind of advice? It is called Yukta Vairagya. Balanced Vairagya. Everything I am doing for Supreme Lord. Each and every action taken by one pure devotee for the total satisfaction of Supreme Lord. For the satisfaction of Supreme Lord. Never they are acting fancifully. Never. So you see, jeva mahi ishe kito suhidartha te yanaha yaneshu dehantaravartikeshu grihesu yatma jaratimatsu napriti yukta javadarthas chaloke. They are not, giving importance to the material world. Automatically. It's an automatic factor. Oh my boys, be careful. Those who are entering into family life, those who are jumping into fire, this family life is just like fire for them. But those who are leading bhakti life, not for them. For them not. Those who are leading bhakti, devotional life, not for them. I already told glorify. That everybody there, those who are Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Parsad, most of them, they are grihastha. So what problem? No problem. But here, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is speaking, Cheta Darpanam Arjanam Bhava Mahadavagni Revaparam, then preliminary you can know that this world is full of fire. Cheta Darpanam Arjanam Bhava Mahadavagni Revaparam, there is forest fire. Dabagni, forest fire, everywhere, each people fighting with you. Each one of them, they like to dominate other. But those Vaishnavas, those who are Vaishnav, pure Vaishnav, they never try to dominate others. In this whole world, you can find this nice picture. Nice in the sense, excellent. Everybody like to dominate other. Hey, you can stay. I can control you. But this is not the case here in devotional life. Each and everybody like to get control over this material universe. But this is not the case with a pure devotee. That's why many times I told in my Harikatha, we want to be controlled by Guru Vishnu. We want to be controlled by the Supreme Divinity. We always and every time want to be controlled by that Supreme Divinity. We want to be controlled by Guru Vaishnav. We are the servant of Guru Vaishnav. Tumi to takur, tomar kukur, boliya jano humore. Oh, Guru Maharaj, I am your dog. What is the duty of dog? Sometime I was bound to write some protest note by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava. Guru Vaishnava request me, order me, you will have to write one protest note. They are speaking this way. So in a very polite way, the word was very strong and judgment was very, very strong on the basis of scriptural analysis. But first of all, in introduction I wrote, I am the dog of Guru Vaishnava. To protect the interest of Guru Vaishnava, I am bound to bark. Bow, go, go, go. I am bound to bark. So what to do? Excuse me. The duty of our dog to protect the interest of his master. So I am dog. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing this way. To teach us, Tumi to Thakur tomaro kukuro বলিয়া জানো মোরে সর্বস্ব তোমার চরণে সে পিয়া পড়েছি তোমারও ঘরে তুমি তো ঠাকুর তোমারও কুকুর বলিয়া জানো মোরে ভক্তি ঠাকুর ইউ মাস্ট সিং ওয়াই ইউ আর সিটিং ডুইং লুকস নেক্সট টু নাথিং অলওয়েজ এভরি টাইম Do kirtan, don't stop while crossing river, going by bus, train, anything what do, don't stop. Always speak. Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasati Gaur Bhaktivinoda Hare Krishna. Always go on, don't stop. If you stop, at that moment Maya can enter your mind and kick you. The moment you forget Supreme Lord and Guru Vishnu. The moment you forget, that is the hole through which the snake Mayadevi can enter. Behula Lokhindar, we hear one nice story from. Huh? Very nice. Huh? One man is supposed to be bit by a snake, but the Jamindar took decision to make an iron room in which, but where from oxygen coming, I don't know. The room, they block, iron room. So no snake can come. Then the goddess of snake come, hey, I can bite you. You will have to keep one small hole so that nobody can know. So that construct, an engineer was bound to keep one small hole through which the snake enter. You see, so that the hole, you are making hole and giving scope to Mayadevi to enter into your mind. Why? So you are responsible for that. So you see, so this way you see, jeva maishe kito sohidartha janeshu dihan taravartikeshu grihes gehe sujayat majarati matsu napriti yukta javadartha sulog. Anyway, if you become mad with this material enjoyment, who is going to protect you? Whereas you are hearing all this advice. So, Rishabhadev speaking, Nunam pramatyam kurute vikarmo yadindriyo pritayu aprinoti na sadhu manne yatvatmano yam asannopi kleshodo asodeho. Actually, those who are, you know, leading their family life in a very fanatic way, like a mad, not thinking about past and future, they are doing and doing everything to get some sensual enjoyment. That's why in Gita, Krishna giving advice, Yehi sangsparsaja bhogaha. In Gita, Krishna giving advice to Arjuna, Arjuna, Yehi sangsparsaja bhogaha. Adyanto banto na teshu ramati budaha. Adyanto banto. Adya jehi sangsparsaja bhoga na teshu ramate budaha. Those who are really intelligent, they never go for sensual enjoyment. Because they know it for sure, it's a kind of bondage for me. Now actually, you see, those who are running like a madman into family life, having no control over their sense organ and mind like madman. If you run your car very madly, you know, then you are going to meet with problem, accident, like Lady Diana. She is not satisfied. Then who can get satisfaction totally? Lady Diana, she married Prince Charles, but still she is not satisfied. Then who can get satisfaction? Running the car with boyfriend, like mad. The car meet with accident, nothing. All gone. This is the condition, ultimate result of material enjoyment. You see, Nunam Pramatya, that's why this of the speaking, Nunam Mananishchita Meva, Nunam Pramatya Kurute Bikarma. Those who are mad, having no control over their sense organ and mind, know it for sure they are going to do Bikarma. Bikarma, you know? Akarma, Bikarma, Karma, Akarma, Bikarma. Bikarma means just opposite of what written in Veda. They are bound to do. Nobody can protect. So mad. Nunang pramatya kurute bikarma jadindriya prita yo apri. They are always thinking about their enjoy, sensual enjoyment. So my son, na sadhu manne yato atmano yam asannapi kleshado asadeho. But I don't think it fit. Rishabhadev speaking, oh my son, I don't think it fit. Because as a consequence, it's very bad. Now suppose you are going to enjoy your life, but in future, you will have to take the reaction. Because as per the third law of Newton in physics, every action has its equal and opposite reaction, you know? Physics. Every action has its equal and opposite reaction. Nobody can cut it. What you are doing at present, you are bound to get the result. Nobody can cut it. No Indra, Varun, Shankar, nobody can cut. Only and only if you can develop that kind of devotion and submit 100% unto lotus feet of pure devotees, like Srila Bhakti Pramodpuri Gishwami Maharaj, Pahupat, Keshub Goswami Maharaj, then and only then you can cut. Oh. If you take Diksha, because taking Diksha, it means to burnt up all your previous results of your activities, all you have done for infinity period. Like in the godown of a straw, if you matches, chuck, put one. Or if you smoke and put that there, in straw go down, then the straw go down with the help of air, oxygen, it can grow, burning. I have seen in Karakpur. I've been there long ago. They invite me in the appearance day of Srila Parampujabad in Janardhan Goswami Maharaj, as a disciple of Prabhupada. I was speaking Harikatha the day I went. At the very next day, it was appearance day, I speak Harikatha. After that, all on a sudden we find one straw go down burning. What's that? Police coming? Who doing this thing? And your godbrother was there. Vishnu Maharaj was there. Burning. I said, what? Same thing. It is like straw go down. If there is, volumes of, papa. Is there, it's a result. But if you take Diksha from Srila Bhakti Bhaiva Puri Goswami Maharaj, is a pure devotee can give Kipa to you. Provided you are getting Diksha 100% perfect. If your Diksha is 100% perfect, then and there you can cut. Then and there. If your Diksha is not perfect, if your submission is not perfect that time, then you're big problem. Diksha kale shishya kare atma samarpan, shei kale krishna tare kare atma sam. The time when one disciple showing 100% submission, doing 100% submission, the moment he become, you know, purified, he get power to give Krishna Bhajan. That's why Rishabhadev speaking, oh my sons, I don't think it fit for you to go for material enjoyment. Na sadmanne yato atmano yam asannapi klesha do asadeho. In future you are going to get reaction, my boys. And in family life, each and every time you are going to meet with some problem, you can get defeated. That is the same thing I explained yesterday, you know. One very poor man, he is taking one small service into one shop of spare parts of motorbike, you know, motorcycle they are selling, spare parts. In that shop, that poor man got service. Doing how much salary he can expect there? Salesman he doing service. But when he got married, that new wife, she is demanding, you will have to give this sari, I need this kind of sari, ornament. Then husband thinking, you know already I am very poor, where to go? I don't know. You will have to go, otherwise I cannot love you. How to get love, material love? He was very interested. Then he was very, you know, honest man. But when wife putting pressure, because otherwise she cannot love me, that is the ultimate goal of family life. Actually, Prahlad Maharaj also speaking. I can discuss this point in seven canto. So that man was bound to steal spare parts very secretly. But first he was very pure, you know, not actually, he was very honest man. What is, you know, master giving? Hey, this kind of donation you can get because Durga Puja coming, this kind of bonus. How much is very small bonus is coming, but wife seeking, no, you will have to give. From then onward, he was bound to steal some spare parts secretly. After the selling it secretly, black market, and getting some money, collecting money to satisfy wife, not to satisfy Supreme Lord. See the situation of family life and try to get lesson out of it. Don't try to obey anybody who is going to give you advice in this material world. You need not give any importance to them. All material people, they can mislead you. So each and every time you are going to meet with defeat, you are going to be defeated all the time. Oh my son, you see, this mind or all this master of all your sense organ, this mind, all in all. Evam mano karma basam prayukte. This mind is automatically, you know, helpless. The sense organ also. Until and unless you grow strong relationship with Vasudev Tattva, why? Rishabhadev, why using this term, Vasudev? Why? What is the reason here? Na priti yavad mai vasude pitir na javad nai vasudeve pitir na javad mai vasudeve na muchyate deho yogena tavat. Oh my son, this is your material mind. I already told this, you know, secret technology. I already told your subtle body, this is a subtle body and fine body. Fine body you cannot say, you cannot see. Fine body, what is the constituent of the fine body? Man, buddhi, chitto, ankara. I already told you. And your mind is material mind is responsible. I mean your fine body is responsible to take you from this body to another body. This is your fine body going to take you away from this material body, this body, and put you another body. There is no respite, you cannot get free. But what is the solution then? That's why I resolved the speaking. Pritir najavad maivasudeve, motir najavad maivasudeve, namochate deho yoge natavad. This kind of living in one body and take another body. Living that body and take another body. It's a must going on. Oh my son, you cannot stop the cycle of your birth and death. Only when you can take shelter of that Vasudev. Why using this term Vasudev? Because basati sarva hidayasu iti Vasudev. In Sanskrit we can explain this way, basati sarva hidayasu, who is sitting in the heart of everybody. His name is Vasudev. Basati tu Vasudev. He is Vasudev. Paramatma is sitting. So until and unless you grow a strong, you know, loveful relation with Pitirnaya, is a Priti. In some book they are reading Motirnajavat. Yes, Priti is also good, very nice. Priti means more high. Moti, attachment, some attachment. Priti means strong affinity. Pritir najavad maivasudeve namuchate deho yoge natavad. Oh my sons, oh my sons, you cannot stop your death and birth until and unless you grow strong affinity unto the lotus feet of that Vasudev. What is the strongest bondage in your life, you know? Oh my son, you don't know. Try to hear very attentively. Pungsa striya mithuni bhava metat tayor mitho hridaya ganti mahu. Pungsa striya mithuni bhava metat tayor mitho hridaya ganti mahu. The knot, you know, locking, the topmost locking. What kind of locking? You are developing your strong love affair with wife and husband. His lost luck. Pungshaha, actually, all jivatma, they are actually purush. This purush, this term, I already explained. Pure dehe basati jivatma iti purushaha. Pure means material body. This jivatma staying here, so it's purusha. I already told two kind of purusha you can find. One is jivatma purusha and as paramatma purusha. Already explained. If you go through each and every word, very minutely, through your whole life, nobody can cheat you. I already promise. So, pungshaha striya, those who are thinking we are men, those who are thinking I am woman, actually false. Not you are not a woman. He is not man, he is not man, you are not woman, you are false. You are, it is one kind of decoration you are given. You are going to leave your body very shortly. And maybe in next life you can take the body of a he-man. You can grow he-man character. And maybe you are man and next time you can become woman. You can take the dress of a woman. Actually, those who are tattva-jnani, they never think that way. Is woman, is man. This is never thing. They realize so. Those realize so, they never think this way. They never think this way. So you see, Pungshaha striya mithuni bhava metvam tayor mitha hidayaganti mahu. It is one kind of the best locking, big locking for you. Then how to get free of this locking? Rishabhadev giving advice, you see. Very nice advice. Hangse guru mohi bhaktyan vritya vitrishnaya dandati tikshaya cha sarvatra jantyor vyasanavagatya yigyasaya tapaseha nivritya. Very nice advice, unique. Each and every time, if you read one sloka and shed tears and dance, is the association of Supreme Lord. Hangse Guru. Hangse. Seventh case ending. Hangse Guru. Hangse Guru means, who is Hangsa? He is Guru. What? You must learn, you see nicely. Hangse Guru Mai Bhaktyanu Vrittya. Paramahansa Guru, Vaishnava, if you serve them, Vaktyanu Vrittya, automatically you can do one thing. Vrittishna Yadanda Titiksa Yacha. Dando mean? Now you are put it into conflicting situation. You have doubt all the time, sometimes feeling good, sometimes feeling bad. Dando. Dando mean? Dando actually, Dando mean fighting. But Dando Samas. A Samas if you do, Hangse Guru. Who is Hangsa? He is Guru. Samas, Karak, you must learn. All we are losing the qualities of devotees here. Very bad. Whole, you know, society going down. We want quality, not quantity. Gorgisar Babaji Maharaj want quantity, not quality. Better in my life I can get one personality who is just sufficient to flourish. You know, this jnana. Hangse guru mai bhaktyanu vrittya vrittishnaya dando titikshayacha. All danda, sometime good, sometime bad, sometime hot, sometime cold, sometime happy, sometime not happy. This is called danda samas. You know, bhalo mondo, rat din. What? So you must cut. You must can automatically, it's a procedure. Through Sadhguru, Paramahansa Guru, Seva, it's a unique procedure. There is no other procedure. The unique procedure. I already told you many times, Krishna Bhagavan speaking in front of Buddha, Buddha. How to cut this material bondage? Many times I told you. Rajastamasya satyena satyancha upasamena cha. Etat sarvam guru bhaktya puruso hi anjasa jayat. Very easily. Material bondage? Material bondage? Yes. Very, it's a matter of chutki. Material bondage, nothing. If your whole life gone to fight with maya, 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 when you can start your bhajan? Do you think you are in maya, you can start bhajan? No. Foolish. Those who are misguiding you. When you are in Maya, you cannot start Hari Bhajan. Not possible. So whole life you strive, you fight with Maya, Maya, Maya. But when you can go out of Maya and start actual Hari Bhajan? Hangse guru mohi bhaktyanu vrithya vrittishnaya dandati tikshaya cha sarvatra jantor vyasunavagatya yigyasaya tapaseha nivritya. Whenever one brahmachari and sannyasi, those who are like to do bhajan, they are looking anywhere. They can see the ultimate result of that thing. For what he is at present feeling some kind of attraction. I am feeling attraction, but the result is very bad. Tattadorshi. If you see anything, those who are tattadorshi purush, you can follow their life. They are not making philosophy in front of you. Foolish person. They in their own life, they are like fire, they are following. Not that they are speaking philosophy in front of you and then backside they are doing all nonsense like idiot. Not that. Don't think that way. Whenever you look, when you are entering into, you know, family life, it's okay. But still you can grow your knowledge. What problem in it? You can go, you know, detachment. No harm in it? What problem? I already told, the topics of Priyavrata, but the advice of Brahma. You can grow detachment gradually, gradually, gradually detachment. Then you can find nothing is there except Krishna. Anywhere you can look, you cannot find there is one lady, there is one man, nothing. You can see all Krishna, all where. Paramatma. Sarvatro yantor vesanavagatya jiggasaya tapasya nivritva. Very nice thing. Sarvatro, wherever you look, you can find the consequence. The result they are going to meet. Another question. If you like to serve the lotus feet of a pure Vaishnava Paramahansa, after that you will have to grow question, self-interrogation. If there is no self-interrogation inside your heart, then you cannot come out successful. If there is no self-interrogation inside your heart, 100% sure, you cannot come out successful. Self-interrogation, who am I, where from I am coming, how long I am going to stay here, what all other facilities staying here, what utility, all you have to think. Until and unless you grow self-interrogation, we cannot expect that you can do bhajan. First symptom, I can discuss from Vedanta, many times I have discussed before, Athoto Brahma Jigyasa. Athoto Brahma Jigyasa. Athato Brahma Jigyasa. And Parikshit Maharaj also putting same question, you see? Parikshit Maharaj? What is my duty? Parikshit Maharaj in front of Sukhdev Goswami, first when he is sitting in Sukhtal, putting this question. What is my duty? What is the duty of those who are going to die today or tomorrow, any time, any moment? Yesterday he is speaking night time. Maharaj, I went to market to buy some fruits. But I see that place is dark and some dhoop and deep going on. I noticed very carefully the man I took fruits from you yesterday, he is now dead. He is speaking tomorrow. Yesterday, night time. Maharaj, I was taking so much fruit from you sometime, buying fruits, bargaining with him. He said, oh Prabhu, niye jao, niye jao, niye jao. But that man is dead. Not so aged. Maybe 55 or 60, maybe hardly 60. Any time, any moment you can die, this feeling should come inside you directly. Not only philosophy. This kind of, you know, question should come inside your heart. Direct feeling, not that philosophy. Well, I know I am going to die. Are you foolish? Not that any moment, any fraction of a second I can die. So until and unless you grow self-interrogation, no question of any improvement. You can do tilak and you can do everything what it concerns to me. So, you will have to grow self-interrogation. Parikshit Maharaj, this same interrogation coming in the life of Parikshit Maharaj. How and when? You already know? I already discussed. Atho prichyami saṃsiddhim yoginam param gurum purusasyeha yat karyam Miyamanasa sarvatha. Those who are going to die, what is the procedure? Can you show? Gurudev, I like to go out of this. But we all like to stay in this material world. We never like to go out of this material world. So much enjoyment here. Who is going to live? This way, you see, this way, Parikshit Maharaj, asking question in front of Sukhdev, how to go out of this question? This is called self-interrogation. And this Rishabhadev giving answer to his 100 songs sitting there. Out of them, Bharat is the topmost, I told you. Now we are going to discuss about the realization of Bharaji Maharaj, the first son of Rishabhadev Maharaj. When father giving advice, Bharatji Maharaj was the topmost personality who could digest the teachings of father and guru. All other sam, Kobir, Habir, Antarikha, Navayoganda, they also could digest. Very nice. Now I am going to speak about the bhajan of, Bharatji Maharaj. In the name of Bharatji Maharaj, India, Bharat, his name came. It's very, very nice personality. Too much sincerity there with Bharatji Maharaj. When he is controlling this human, kingdom, after some time he took decision to leave all wife and treasure, kingdom, everything, and go to forest and start bhajan very nicely. What is the spot? Whenever you like to go to Kali Gandaki, Nepal, Gandaki Nadi, one river, at the bank of Gandaki, you can find nice place. When you travel, you can in hilly place. At the bank of Gandaki Nadi, you can find forest. Then Bharatji Maharaj gone. Is going there and started bhajan very nicely. Very nicely. Total concentration. In very morning time, going to Gandaki Nadi to take bath, sun rises, doing bhajan nicely. Gayatri Adi, sun rises, paid under with everything. In water itself, hot and summer and winter season, not same thing. So after that, you see, first of all, I like to say this Rsabhadev, for the reason for why Rsabhadev coming in this material world, first of all, I like to speak about that. After that, I can speak about that Bharatji Maharaj. Rsabhadev Ji Maharaj is the incarnation of Supreme Lord. So nice looking, what to speak. Ajang Lambita Bhujo, Kanakabada, very nice, Paddhapara, petals of lotus flower, eyes. So nice, soft hand and legs. If you look, you can go mad. But now, and this chest is, Supibhya Bakkasthal. Chest is, very mighty man. Now Rishabhadev now took decision to go to forest and do bhajan. He wanted to exhibit the Paramahamsa Dharma. For what? The reason for why he is coming here? To give you some lesson. Already you heard some lesson teachings of Rishabhadev. Now Rishabhadev is going to leave his body. What he is doing? He leave all kingdom, everything, all treasure, wife, everything, going alone, naked. No clothes is there. His head now is, curled, here. You see, the body become black with all dust coming, no washing, nothing. He wanted to exhibit himself like a crazy man. He started doing bhajan like ajagar tapasi, like python lying, a python for a long time lying in one place. By chance, one food coming in front of his mouth is taking, always not lying, a python. He cannot find any action in the life of python. It's called one kind of tapasya, ajagar tapasya. Now Rishabhadev started exhibiting this Paramahamsa Dharma, and now what he is doing, he is lying in one place like ajagar, like python. Somebody giving food, bread, chapati, fruits, anything, taking. Not giving for long time, not taking. Passing tools in same place. All stools and urine, you know, all his body full up. Like Gomata. Cow dung is there, Gomata, sitting there. All cow dung. Like, you know, this Rsabhadev now exhibiting there like, you know, like crazy man. All stools and urine, all full, his body. All stools and urine. But very nice. Nice, you know, scent. Nice scent. Stool and urine, not bad smell. It's written there. Kilometers. A kilometers of my, no. Wherever this air going, oh, nice smell. Like scent. Very nice smell. Like dup. Dup, you know? Very nice. Everywhere, nice smell. So you know, understand that Rishabhadev is not ordinary personality. He is an incarnation of... It is written, man. Come on. I am not, you know, hitting. Tasso haja purisho surabhir saugandha vayustvam desham daso yojanam samantyat surabhim chakaraha. It is written. Das jojon. Das jojon mean how to calculate. I forget calculation. One jojon, big thing. 10 jojon. Wherever this air going off, nice smell of flower, you see, and scent. Tasho haja purisho surabhi saugandha vayustvam desham das jojonam samantat surabhim chakaraha. Now Rishabhadev wanted to leave his body. First he is going to South India, in Karnataka here and there, traveling in, you know, in forest here and there. After that someday, forest fire took place. After that, after some time, some days, fire, forest fire took place. Glowing fire. Rishabhadev inside fire, sitting and leave his body. Without any reaction. Now Rishabhadev leaving his body. Yai Rishabhadev Bhagavan ki jai. Sixth chapter now. Now here we see so many, you see, glorification of Rishabhadev we can find. So many glorification of Rishabhadev. Now actually we are going to enter into seventh chapter. Shukdev Goswami speaking. The elder son of Rishabhadevji Maharaj, somehow he is growing detachment. Someday he is leaving everything and going to forest to start bhajan very extensive, a very, very nice way. You know, Sukhdev Goswami now speaking, Bharatastu Mahabhagavato Yada Bhagavatavani talo paripalanayo sanchintitos tadanu sasana paraho panchat janin visvarupo duhitaram upojeme Bharatastu Bharat Maharaj panchat janin one, you know, visvarupo duhiti buhitri, the daughter of visvarup Panchajani. This Bharat Maharaj now marry that lady. Bharatastu Mahabhagavato Yada Vagabhatavanitala Paripalanayo Sanchintitahastadanu Shasana Paraha Panchajanin Visvarupa Dhitaram Upojeme. He is ruling his own country. Nice. After that got married, after that, you know, creating, you know, five sons. Sumati, Rashtrabhrit, Sudarshan, Avaran, Dhumraketu. And you know, Barsho, Ajanava Barsho, first I told you, that Barsho now become famous as Bharat Barsho. Ajanava Barsho. No, by the name of Bharat Maharaj. You are so strong and doing bhajan nicely. Now leaving everything and going to forest. And after that you see, he is going to Pulaha Ashram. Pulaha Rishi, one big Rishi, he used to do bhajan there in Pulaha Ashram. That's why we speak as Pulaha Ashram. Pulaha Ashram is a place where Pulaha Rishi long ago used to do bhajan there. That's the same place where Bharat Maharaj is teaching. Nobody there, he started bhajan very nicely. Now actually, is doing bhajan very nicely there. He used to do bhajan, you know, Bhargodev. When sun rises, he can see the Bhargodev inside the sunlight, glowing sun. Also today, if you can have the power to see Supreme Lord there, when we are doing Gayatri, if you do Gayatri this way, you can find the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu there. When sun rises, you can say golden plate. Oh, very powerful. If you are doing exact bhajan, you can find Chaitanya Mahaprabhu there, Bhargodev. You can find Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the golden complexion there. He can bless you. But if you are blind, you cannot see anything. So this Bharaji Maharaj used to do bhajan very nicely. Morning time taking bath and watching the sun when rises and meditating on the lotus feet of that Bhargodev. Meditating onto the lotus feet of that Bhargodev. Bhargo Divasya. No, I should not speak in front of public. It's not good. You know, this way, you know, doing bhajan. His bhajan is very perfect. He is going very nicely with his bhajan. But someday one thing happens. What happens? Because I already told, Bhagavan going to test you. Each and every time, Supreme Lord want to test you. Before accepting you, Supreme Lord always try to test you. Whether you are fit or not. Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking in Gita also, those who are je yathamang prapadyante tang stateiva bhajami aham. Bhagavan Sri Krishna giving this, you know, speaking in Gita, je yathamang prapadyante tang stateiva bhajami aham. Those who are worshipping me, I watch which way they are worshipping me. Have some doubt, have some desire. So, I also, they are doing my bhajan. I like to pay them salary. Salary, you know, like a paid man. Oh, you are giving service. Hey, pay him. He is doing the service. I also in my life, I have given service. I mean paying salary to so many person. I keep them with love and respect. Ultimately, I see they want salary from me. I give salary and go away. Take salary and go away. Many people cheating me. Many people in my life. I give them salary and go. So Supreme Lord also want to give. He is the super personality. So je yathamang prapadyante tang stateiva bhajami aham. According to their, you know, tenacity of bhajan, I am also get ready to pay them. What do you want? Siddhi? You want money? Position? Take. But for Gopikas, for Bhujavasis, Krishna cannot pay them. Krishna speaking, I am foolish. I cannot pay them. I have nothing to pay to you. You all doing seva to me in such a way, I have nothing to pay you. I can speak this point in 10 canto. I have nothing to pay you. This way Krishna speaking in front of those gopikas. But for other people, Krishna like to pay. Doing bhajan? Is doing this bhajan? Take salary and go. Yes. Krishna like to give salary. Very nice. Krishna is very clever. He like to test you very much. This way, you see, now actually, ye yathamang prapadyang te tang stataiva bhajamiyam, this Krishna's, this kind of promise, you know, is broken in front of those Brajagopikas. Now, what to do? Now actually, Krishna is doing nice bhajan right from the morning time. And when he is looking at the sun god, he can clearly see that Bhargadev is there inside the sun god.
Evam karmo visuddhya visuddha satya svantar hridaya kasu sarire brahmani bhagavati vasudeve mahapurusha rupopo lakshane Si Batso Kostuva Bhavano Mala Bhajan Sri Kostuva Bhano Mala Di Bhano Mala Ridaro Gada Divi Rupalakshite Nijo Purusho Hrit Lakshite Natmani Purusho Rupena Birochamana Uchaistaram Bhaktim Anudinam Medamana Raya
Ajayata. Here it is written, day by day he is going to cut the all material, you know, things from inside heart. He is purifying himself. And he can see, meditate, and Sun God, their Supreme Lord. Sri Kostubo Banamaladi Maladi Bala Mala Ridaro Gada Divi Rupalakshite Gada Sankajago Gada Pati, you can see Kostubo Banamala. This way. But one day you see how to maintain body? But like Rishi Mani. Those who are Rishi Mani maintaining their life. And speaking,
Yatro ho Baba Bhagavan Hari Radyapi Tatro Tyanam Nijo Jananam Batsalena Sannidhapattu Icharupena.
That is a unique place, Siddha place. Where still today, if some devotee doing bhajan with great tenacity, they can take the darshan of Supreme Lord in different form. Supreme Lord coming still there, in different form. Sometime in the form of Rishi, sometime in different form, and coming in front of. Here is Rishi.
Yatroho Babu Bhagavan Hari Radyapi Tatro Tyanam Nijo Jananam Batsalena Sannidha Patto Icha Rupena.
Still Supreme Lord is there. Always there.
But actually, Tatra Sramopadani Uvayuto Nabhivir Rishat Chakrair Mas Chakra Nadim Namo Saritravara Saravatahu Pavitri Karoti.
One river, Gandaki Nadi. Coming here and divided into two parts. Gandaki Rodi coming, Gandaki River. Gandaki River coming, divided into two parts and just circle, just like parikram and going on.
Tatra sramapadan ubhayato nabhivi drishat chakrair chakranadi namo sarit pravara sarvatoho pavitri karoti.
This way, that heaven, this river purifying the whole place, you see. That place is very nice. In this Pulhasram, he is going to do bhajan very nicely. Who? Bharat Maharaj. In that ashram, explaining, Tasmin babu kilo sa ekalaha pulahasramopabane vivido kusumo kisalayo tulasi kambudi kando mulo phalo puharischa samihamano bhagavato aradhanam vivikto uporato visayavilaso uposang vrito pasamaha param nibritim abapo mabapo. Tasmin babo kilo sa ekalaha pulahasramopabane vivido kusumo kisalayo tulasikam budhi kando mulo phalop harischo samihumano bhagavato aradhanam bibikto uparato visayahi laso uposangvrito upasamaha param nibritim mabapaha. Huh? What's that? That ashram, Pulahasram, so pure, all around different so nice garden made by Supreme Lord. He is going to collect fruits and flowers from there. Tulasi, nice. Tulsi pata, manjuri, everything. And with that, you know, collected, you know, food, flowers and, you know, fruits, everything, tulsi, making garland. And worshipping that Supreme Lord, oh Prabhu, be satisfied. This way, very nicely. Tasmin babu kilo sa ekalaha, nobody there. Alone, doing bhajan nicely. Tasmin babu kilo sa ekalaha, pulaha stramopabani bibidot kusumot. Kishalayo tulasi kambudhi kando mulu farupaharischa samihamano bhagavato aradhanam vivikto uparato visayavilaso upo sangvrito upasamo paramane vritim mabapo. Now he is self-contained. He is not feeling any attraction from this material world. Still, Supreme Lord is going to test him. Now you are not feeling any attraction for material thing? No. Be careful. Don't believe your mind. Don't try to believe your mind is a traitor number one. Traitor number one can cheat you anytime. You are feeling, no Maharaja, at present it's okay, I find. No. Anytime that mind can cheat you, it's a number one cheater, you see. Anytime you can be in problem, you see. Narad Bharaji Maharaj doing bhajan, sometimes tears rolling down his cheeks, trying some ecstatic feeling. Mind is almost under control, no sense organ making any problem, staying in one place doing bhajan nicely. Still, Supreme Lord wanted to test him. Okay, everything okay? Huh? Everything okay? Now I like to test you. I like to test you. What kind of testing? One day, Bharaji Maharaj going to take bath in river Gandaki Nabhi. Doing bhajan nicely, chanting Gayatri and looking, waiting for the sun to rise, and ultimately on sun he can consent it that Bhargodev, he can see Supreme Lord. Eh? In the meantime, one thing happens. What happens? Se Suk Vacho, Ashtamodaya, 8th chapter. Ekodatu Mahanadyam Kritavi Seko Naya Mikavasyaku Brahmyaksharam Abhigrinnano Muhuttatrayam Udokantu Upobivishaha. Ekodatu Mahanadyam Kritavi Sheko Naya Mikavashako Brahmyaksharam Abhigrinnano Muhuttatrayam Udakanto Upo Viveshaha. One day he gone to Mahanadyam, not Mahanadi, actually there is no Mahanadi here. It is term given Mahanadi, Gandaki Nadi actually. Mahanadi Gandaki is coming from nice place. After that, Muhutratrayam. Muhutratrayam mean? Muhutratrayam means 25 minutes multiplied by 3. One Muhutra is 24 minutes. And Khattangureji got success within Muhutra. After that, you see, then he was waiting and doing bhajan nicely there. Ekodatu mahanadyam kritavisheko nayamika avashyako. What all he need to do for his bhajan, he was doing everything, almost complete. Ar brahmyaksharo avigrinyano. Brahmaksharo mean om. You should not utter om. Om everybody cannot utter. It's sinful. Ar brahmaksharam avigrinyano. Also brahmakshar is equal to brahmagayati also, maybe. Brahmaksharo, we can think it is chanting Brahma Gayatri and Brahma Muhurtva. Brahma Muhurtva means sun going to rise. In the morning time, at least within 3 o'clock, you must get up and start bhajan. If you cannot, don't come to me. Those who cannot get up 3 o'clock, they go away from me. I cannot allow them to come and taunt me. So strict. You know, this way, you say, doing bhajan, brahmaksharam avigrinyano muhutatrayam udakanto upavivesha is sitting. At the same time, one incident happens. What happens? Tatro tada rajano harini pipa saya jala saya bhyaso. But here, one deer, sea deer coming. Tatro tada rajan harini pipasaya jalasaya bhyasa me koiva upojagamaha. That time by chance, one, you know, harin, sea deer, coming. And taking water, his sea is very thirsty, taking water from Gandaki Nadi. So what problem? No problem. But in the meantime, one thing happens. What that? Taya mane teno pepiyo mane mana tadara jol khawar somoy aitake taya pepiyo mano udake tabo deba bidureno nodato mrigo pater urunado loko vayankaro udapatat. One breath you have to speak, then you are Brahman, otherwise not. You have to control. You know, this way, he is watching. Then when she is taking, you know, drinking water, in the meantime, she heard from distant place one, the sound of one, you know, lion. And naturally, deer is very fear. Deer is fear. Deer always in fear. You know, deer is so light-hearted. Anytime when tiger running behind it, maybe tiger cannot touch. But if his, you know, this, you know, horn stuck up with bunches, then he's thinking, but say, tiger, catch me, heart fell, die. Yes, Harini is so light-hearted. Harini is so light-hearted. Cannot be, I think already I'm dead. A heart fell and died. You know, tatro, he sound one sound, gum, one sound of lion. See, thought lion coming and catching me. What to do? Where to go? Jump into water. Nothing there. Backside lion. In front water, where to go? She took decision to jump into water. But with that jumping, she was actually pregnant. That time, one, you know, small baby coming out of body. Now, see, heart fell. Die. And that baby, without knowing anything, very nice looking, very small baby, is because this hilly river, water flowing down, that, you know, that baby, with water flow going down. Now, Raja, that king, I mean, now king, not king, Bharat Maharaj is thinking, what's that? Big problem again? A baby, mother gone, mother died already. That baby also going. It is my responsibility to protect that baby. In front of me, nobody there. So it is my duty to protect that baby. See, jump into water and go with current and catch that baby. And washing and come back. And from that time, he started loving that baby, kissing him. Very nice, keeping with me. Arranging milk in forest, giving milk sometimes fruits, did that. He'd get, always taking care of that baby. What to do? Gradually, that Bharat Maharaj getting engagement in his service and in the service of that baby. It takes time. Previously, it was whole day is Krishna Bhajan time. In our life, what? Any time is Krishna Bhajan time. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told? What told Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? Kiswayane ki bhajane kimba jagarane ahar nishu chinte Krishna valoha badane. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you are not following. No, I am taking that. Don't disturb me. What kind of rest you like to take? Harikatha is rest. Some devotee coming from, you know, Midnapur, he helped me to get that baby, calf, very nice. He's saying, Maharaj, in noontime when I play my harikatha, then my wife speaking, let me take rest, don't disturb me. Yes. He's speaking this way. What do you see? So everybody feel disturbed. If absolute truth, if some sadhu speaking about that absolute truth, then everybody is speaking disturbed. Why are you speaking this way? Why not in other way? They feel disturbed. So this way, you see, now that Bharat Maharaj is engaged in different kind of seva, other than the seva of Supreme Lord, arranging foods and flour, everything okay. Bharat says he need to arrange some milk also for that baby. Where to go? In tribal's room. He need to go to different place to collect milk. And that is forest. No privilege there. No facility there. When the baby grown up, then he is taking, hey, go with me to collect fruits and flower. That baby also going behind. Like pet dog. Going. In the meantime, you see, day by day, unknowingly, Bharati Maharaj losing his bhajan. He couldn't realize this point. Day by day, losing bhajan. It's my duty to serve. Fruits and flowers collecting for long time, coming back from forest, and purify and sit with water and everything, that the deer, baby deer, from backside, you know, pushing him. Hey, you play with me. Hey, let me worship first. I can play with you after. Again, dressing. Play with me now, that baby, dear babies. Sometime he is doing bhajan very nicely, closed eye. And when open eyes, you see, all he is taking fruits and, you know, grass. Hey, you waste? Yes. Ha! Again, clean that place, go to forest, again freshly collect fruits and flowers, everything come. Hey, now don't disturb. I'm doing bhajan. Pushing from backside with one. Play with me. Hey, let me worship first. I can play with you after. This way, unknowingly, Bharatji Maharaj losing all his bhajan. Bhajan gone. And one day, by the mercy of Maya Devi, one day, evening time, he is not, where is that baby? When he is doing bhajan at the bank of Gandaki Nodi, sometime doing bhajan, and what? Where gone that baby? Hey! Oh, he's here. Okay. Again doing bhajan. Again after some watching. Where the baby gone? This way, all his anxiety growing inside her. And one day, that baby gone. Where gone? Bharat Maharaj crying. Oh, Sun God, have you seen that dear baby? Huh? Where gone? Night time crying, that baby not coming back. I am very cruel actually. I am merciless. Why I allow that baby to stay alone? I will have to get that, you know, result for that. Mother gone, that baby helpless. It is my duty to help, you know, protect, but I am really merciless. This way thinking. After that baby not coming back. Bharati Maharaj feeling sick day by day, losing his mentality to bhajan. After that, ultimately going to leave his body. And while leaving body, thinking about that dear baby. Then he took the birth as a dear baby in some place. He couldn't come out successful. Bharati Maharaj, he is living whole opulences, you see, so big king. All daughters, son, you know, wife, all big treasure, so power, all losing, all throwing and like garbage and coming into forest. Now again he is put it into illusion. Oh my God. He throw everything like garbage. But by the mercy of Mayadevi again he is put it into problem. Maya, illusion, what's that? He become, took the birth as a dear baby. Jang jang baopi swaranam bhavam tejati ante kalevaram. Krishna speaking. But you are thinking at the time of your death, you are going to take that kind of facility. You know. At the time of death, you can get that kind of journey. What you are thinking about at present. This way, you see, this way actually, Bharati Maharaj doing bhajan, but now losing bhajan totally and take the birth, living body and take the birth as dear baby. This is the result, consequent, you will have to meet. Be careful. After that, how he is doing bhajan, again come back and come out successful. At Jarawarji Maharaj, I can discuss everything tomorrow. Jeva vayishe kitasau hidartha yaneshu dehantaravartikeshu gesu jayatma yarati matsu na priti yukta javadartha chaloke vancha kalpaturva sikvasin bevasha patitanam pavana bevasha bhyo namo. It is my request to you all, after Harikatha is over, at least for 10 minutes, you will have to do Sankirtan. Don't follow me. Everybody should do Sangha. It is the rules by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Don't stop and run. Let me go, but you stay 10 minutes only. Do Sankirtan loudly. The ultimate thing you will have to do. Don't go with me. You stay and do Sankirtan for some time. After that you can go.